What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Kelly. We are back with another video, guys. If you are new and you're clicking on this channel for the first time, if you guys like what you hear and you're into true crime and news, politics, and culture, all of that good stuff, go ahead and give me a subscribe, guys. I would greatly appreciate that. And if you are returning to the channel and you've already subscribed, I appreciate y'all, and I'm honored to have you guys here. It means a lot to me. So, I wanted to jump on here, guys. This will be a pretty quick video, just a little update, okay? Because, I made a video yesterday about Madison Brooks, and if you guys didn't watch that, it'll be linked at the, at the end of this video, so definitely go check that out. And, I was pretty upset yesterday, to say the least, okay, because after reading the story, and I've been doing some research on this for the past, pretty much week since it's come out, just trying to kind of piece, together what it is that may or may not have happened, and just trying to gather my own opinion and my own, do my own research and all of that stuff. And, I made the video, and I still stick by what I said, but I was very, strong, I came up pretty strong last night, but I wanted to not clarify in this video, but I wanted to show you guys some new, CCTV footage that just came out today. So a lot of people are talking about this. A lot of people are saying, that this, oh my gosh, this just proves everything. These guys are going to be released, there's not going to be any charges. So I saw this footage, and I want to know what you guys think, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and just start off with that. No further commentary until we watch this video together. And I want to know what you guys think about this, and does this totally clear things up for y'all? So let's get into it, guys. And this is from New York Post. Okay, let's watch this real quick. Absolutely not. Let me make it bigger. And there is a timestamp, I believe. This little bar might be in the way, but because that was one thing. I saw the video and I was like, well, what is the time? The first video I saw, I was like, what is the timestamp? But the timestamp does match up. Okay, you can't see it from this angle, but it does match up. I was able to see that it did. It shows this is around 1:50 a.m. So let's watch this, and then I will give a little bit further commentary. Chilling surveillance video obtained by WAFB reportedly shows LSU student running across the street towards the young man accused of raping her before she was struck and killed by a car. 19-year-old had met the group at Reggie's Bar in East Baton Rouge before getting into their car, where she was allegedly raped by two of the men in the backseat before being dropped off at a nearby subdivision where she was hit by a car. Investigators said Brooks had a blood alcohol content of 0.319, nearly four times the legal limits, and Reggie's Bar has had its liquor license revoked after the incident. So, what do y'all think about that? Oh, gosh, not this. Oh, another horrifying... Oh, my gosh, y'all. We haven't talked about, Idaho 4 in a while, but anyways, that's a totally different subject. But what did y'all think about that video? I don't know. Obviously I think that it's meant to look a particular way, but it doesn't convince me of anything really, honestly. I mean, the only thing it maybe convinces me of is that she, the stories are definitely all over the place. The accounts given to police, do not really seem to match each other or what we're seeing here, because from what was explained in the affidavit, the one 18-year-old subject who was being accused of raping her said that he was walking behind them, and that the 17-year-old was walking with Madison back to the car, and they all said that she was stumbling, that she was falling over, and all of those things very well may be true. This was such a short clip that I just think that this was put out there. I don't know what the motives were. I just think that people are doing a whole lot of justification for something that happened to this girl. And I get it. Like, if these guys didn't rape her, which, I mean, my opinion really hasn't changed. It's all alleged anyways, but my opinion on that has not changed yet. I have not seen enough evidence to say without a shadow of a doubt, oh yeah, they didn't do it. They're innocent. Free them, you know? No. I think that what happened that night was nefarious. There was, you know, something going on where they were taking advantage of a girl that they could see was physically drunk. I mean, I think that, like, a 10-second clip of her running across the street and not falling down doesn't prove anything. It doesn't prove that, oh, she was totally fine. Like, you know, she was able to run across the street after. She was running after them. Like, she was asking for it. She was wanting it, you know? Like, somebody in the comments was like, oh, yeah, she wanted that dark meat or something like that. Just, like, really gross stuff. And this is all I've been seeing with this case, which really makes me even more upset. And it just kind of, like, takes the wind out of your sails when you see that this is how people act towards one another. And I think that it's this case has already been so polarized to the point where it's, like, you're either, like, totally unwilling to see a perspective from either side or, like, in the middle. You're either, like, on one side or the other. And I'm trying to be, you know, to take a step back and just look at it from the middle. But I still feel the way that I feel because ultimately a young woman ended up dying. You know, these four men did not know her before this night. They met her at this bar and admittedly to their own, you know, their own words, their own like statements said that she was drunk. She was so drunk that she was falling over. She didn't know where her friends were. She didn't know where her home was. And, you know, she was, like, just completely inebriated. And her blood alcohol shows that as well. Then why would y'all continue to put yourself in that situation? You know, if anything, let's say, like, you know, let's just say that these men are all innocent, okay? What can we learn from this? Young men, do better. Like, do better. Like, don't put yourself in that situation. This was a pretty girl. So I think that to say that, like, this was all above board and everybody was completely innocent, the guys had no negative intents with this, you know, chauffeuring a drunk girl home at 2 in the morning, I think you're lying to yourself if you think that. But it can be used as a learning experience. If they are innocent and they do, and that does end up coming out that they are, which, whatever, fine. You know, I can be wrong. But I'm just saying, like, y'all have to do better for yourselves as well. You know, I am all about protecting both men and women. You know, it's not just, I'm not just like a, I'm definitely not a feminist whatsoever. So I'm not just all about, you know, like, oh, believe all women. I think that's bullshit. But my mantra is believe, like, myself. Like, that's why I try to do my own research. And I go with my gut, you know, like I really just truly try to look at it from all sides. And then whatever I feel like is in my heart and like, you know, I feel like it is just, it's like a, I don't know, like a conscientious thing, like a just a feeling that I get, you know, like where I just feel like, okay, this is the way that I feel and I'm gonna stand on it, you know. So like that's what I try to do. And I try to come at it from a well-researched and educated perspective, which is, I feel like, the right thing. But in this case, you know, men have to do better as well as women, you know? Everybody was wrong in some degree on this night. But those men were ultimately, I believe, allegedly, at fault for this because they didn't, instead of just like, you know, being like, no, we're not going to take you home. We don't know you and you need to get a safe ride home and we're going our own separate way. They inserted themselves, put themselves in jeopardy. And then whenever things supposedly went wrong, whatever happened in that car, put this woman out in the middle of the street at 3 in the morning. I mean, it just, you cannot say that they didn't do anything wrong. You can't. I mean, so let me read you guys this article, and then we'll get on out of here. And I do just want to point out, I pulled these maps back up, okay? And I think it, from what I'm gathering now, like, it was possibly confirmed, still not 100% sure, that she was staying at the sorority house. So again, I just want to point out, you know, the distance from the bar to the sorority house, which is all located pretty centrally here on campus, okay? Right here, you know, the campus is here, the sorority house is here, the bar is here, and they drove her from the bar all the way down Burbank, pretty far, until they got to this road here, Pelican Lakes, this neighborhood, where they then dropped her off. Where is it? Is it right here? I think it's this little windy road. Yeah. Okay, Pelican Lakes, yeah. So let me zoom out again just so I can see the distance, okay? Why? It's still like, I still have the same questions that I had last night, you know? I don't care what the footage shows, you know, like, she could have been trying to suck their dick in the bar. I wouldn't have cared. I mean, that has nothing to do with anything. Do you guys realize that, like, a woman can still be raped even though she is giving consent and she might be into it, but then things might go completely left, and then at that point she no longer wants to give consent to her body, or maybe she gave consent to one of the guys and then ended up being... you know, taken advantage of by the second guy. Like, do you guys realize that things like that happen? You know, yep, y'all realize that? No? Okay, so that's my whole point, is it's just like, something's wrong here. Something is wrong based on the information that I have seen, the statements that were made. You cannot convince me that they're everything was above board and that these guys are all 100% innocent when there was confirmed sexual activity that happened inside of a car with this girl who didn't know any of these men. Two of the guys never left the car, were watching. I don't know. And people also in the comments were saying that, like, oh, y'all don't understand how girls are these days. Like, they're freaks, you know, like, these young girls are, like, they're down for anything. Like, they'll do threesomes with guys. Like, they'll, you know, get trains run on them. And, you know, that, as gross as that is, might be true. And young ladies, if you're doing that out there, oh God, please, please stop. Please don't. Please value yourself more, because that is just, man, that's just, that's very sad. And you're worth more than that. We all are. Even young men, you guys are worth more than that too. Since when did we, I mean, I guess I know, since, you know, ever since the sexual revolution is when we really started going downhill. But, like, when are we going to turn this thing around and realize that, like, you don't need to have countless sexual partners and, you know, have sex with anything that comes across your radar in order to, you know, add value to yourself. Like, you're worth more than that. I don't know. So people were just saying all kinds of everything. Like I said, it just seems like a whole lot of justification for what is very likely to have been some sort of rape that happened, whether it be by both of the guys or by one of the guys, or, you know, who knows? We just don't know. These four are, you know, they're going to be working together. They're going to be covering for each other until, you know, possibly somebody turns against the others. I don't know. I see that, you know, as things progress here, I feel like we're going to see somebody turn on somebody else, but who knows, guys? So I want to get into the article here. This is from MSN via Fox News. So, okay, is this the one? Yeah. Okay. Days since Madison Brooke was allegedly assaulted, shortly before she was fatally struck by a car, the men accused of crimes against the LSU sophomore have been released from jail after posting a combined $275,000 in bond. So, okay, so they were arrested, they bonded out. Prosecutors have reportedly indicated they will be seeking upgraded charges against the suspects, whose attorneys have argued Brooks consented to the sex and the suspects have not committed any crimes. So, okay, so they go on to talk about the bar and how the bar now has their lawyer coming up here and saying that they're cooperating and all this. And look at this shot. Like, I mean, look at this shot. Well, actually, yeah, look at this shot. But they're advertising, and I've been to this bar before, 50 Cent Shot Night, Thursday. Okay, girls no cover until whenever. So they obviously are you know, catering to cheap drinks, 50-cent shot night.
Wow.
Count me in. But, you know, they have some sort of liability in this too, but I still stick by my original statement that, like, we cannot be pointing our finger at some inanimate, like, in, you know, some, oh, it's about being overserved. It's the bar's fault. Yes, I mean, the bar might have overserved her, but really, we need to be looking culturally at what is going on with our young men and our young women. And why are they so broken that they feel that they can do something like this when it comes to the young men, and that she felt that it was a good idea for her to put herself in that situation? You know, like, what, how can we uplift people, especially our young people, and how can we turn, you know, the tide into a more moral society where we don't have to worry so much about things like this? We're always going to have, you know, people who are violent, people who are going to, you know, harm others, but it's becoming more and more prevalent, and it's, like, really getting scary. So it's like, we cannot keep just blaming all these inanimate objects like bars and alcohol and the, you know, underage drinking and it's the, you know, this and that. No, it's something wrong with the mental, the, you know, the brains and, like, the mentality of these, you know, these younger people and older people alike, all people. Americans, we have issues. Like, we have mental issues, a lot of us, and it is causing, you know, a mental health crisis on, like, you know, the likes of which we haven't seen. I truly feel like that. This is only going to get worse if we don't do something about it. So, you know, like I said, start uplifting young people, like, make, you know, instill in them values that would make them not want to have all these multiple sexual partners, and might have, instead, a relationship with God, might value their bodies, might not, you know, put themselves in a situation where they can then be accused of rape and, you know, be involved with the death of a young girl, a 19-year-old girl, because y'all put her out the car. I mean, it's just, can we start making better choices and having more accountability, and parents start actually parenting their children to where they know better? I mean, just thought. I don't know. Okay, so this is kind of like a timeline. We already kind of went over this yesterday. So at 1 a.m., according to the affidavit, Brooks is seen sitting on a stool at Reggie's before she stands up to readjust her pants and stumble backwards. The victim got back on her feet with the help of three individuals. At 1:34, Brooks falls while standing up from a bench near the entrance of Reggie's bar, the affidavit says. The 17-year-old suspect is then allegedly seen approaching Brooks. He removed her baseball cap, and Brooks is seen grabbing the teen's hands while getting back on her feet. Okay, so the at 1:49, Brooks and the four men leave Reggie's bar. At 1:51, they are seen walking towards the location of their parked vehicle, and then the group boards the vehicle. And at 2:50, the traffic division receives a call about a fatal crash on Burbank where Brooks is struck by a car. So let's look at this scene here, guys. I guess this is where she was at. Let me see. Let me make this bigger. Let's go to the beginning. So this looks like she had gotten, like, she was not even by the front of the neighborhood. Looks like she was, she had walked a little ways. And it's still unclear to me whether she was struck walking along the side of the road or if she was in the middle of the road. I don't know if they ever actually clarified that. But, yeah, this looks like she wasn't even in front of that neighborhood like I originally had thought. But, my God, dude, like, and it's just so crazy to me that, like, I mean, these cars don't look, I mean, they're going fast, yes, but it's, like, it's insane to me that, like, just being hit in this circumstance, like, you know, you're hit by a car, that it can kill you just like that. I mean, it's just, I don't know. I mean, I get it. Yeah, it's like, duh, Kelly. Yeah, a car can kill you. But I don't know. It just seems like she was a young, vibrant young woman. Like, how did this happen? It's just so tragic in every single way. So, okay. The person who struck Brooks was not impaired and contacted emergency personnel immediately. And the driver does not face any criminal charges. And I pray for him as well, because that's a horrifying thing to have to go through, knowing that, you know, you were the cause of someone's death. You know, ultimately, I truly don't blame it on that person. I blame it on the people who abandoned her there. And, you know, say what you want, but it's like y'all made the choice to give her a ride home and to, you know, take responsibility. So y'all should have, if y'all did not want to see that all the way through, then y'all should have never told that girl to get in your vehicle. I'm sorry. That's just how I feel. So y'all let me know what y'all think. Okay. So let's see. I think there was one other thing. Carver allegedly tells police the victim walked with them as they were leaving the bar. He says Brooks was very unstable on her feet and was not able to keep her balance and was unable to speak clearly without slurring her words. So, like, yeah, all these statements go against, like, you know, what we saw on that, like, 10 to 15 second clip of her running across the street. People were like, oh, this proves it all. She was fine. Like, she, look at her running. Look at her. Look at her on 2 feet, you know? First of all, this video was taken from a long, like, bird's eye view shot away. And, you know, it doesn't really prove anything at all. It just proves that, like, for 10 seconds she was able to run across the street. So, I don't know. I mean, everyone else who gave statements that night were saying that she was falling down drunk. So, I don't know, y'all. So, I don't want to get too far into the weeds, but I did just want to come on here and show you guys that video and see what y'all thought about it. So, again, they're just kind of reiterating how drunk she was. They all knew that they could visibly see that she was drunk. He didn't know, she didn't know her address, or she wasn't able to provide it to him. So, you know, at that point, you gotta start being smarter, guys. Don't put yourself in the situation, because if you do, then you are taking some sort of responsibility and you will be held accountable if something bad happens. You know, just don't even put yourself in the situation. So, I don't know. What do y'all think, guys? I think it's just tragic all the way around. People's lives have been ruined. This beautiful girl's life was lost. It's just a polarizing situation where everyone is like, you know, going back and forth, pointing the finger at the victim who lost her life, saying, you know, that she was asking for it, that she was wanting it, that she was this, that, and the other thing. She was too drunk. She should have never been there. You know, just like all of this. And then on the other hand, you know, making excuses all around and saying that these guys are totally innocent. And I just don't see it that way. Even if they are, quote unquote, innocent, they're not. Because what they did was wrong by, you know, even engaging in that whole situation with her. And knowing what they expressed in their statements to police, that she was falling down drunk. And then you just leave her on the side of the road? Even if nothing else happened. That's wrong. I'm sorry, it is. So, the last thing I want to read to you guys was this. This is what I was looking for. Okay, so, all three adult suspects appear in court for bond hearings. Judge Brad Myers from the 19th Judicial District says he personally had viewed footage related to the case, according to local news station. Myers said he watched a video of Brooks and the suspects from inside the vehicle, according to the report. Myers said footage, which was allegedly taken by one of the four suspects, depicted the others callously laughing at Brooks, who appeared to slur as she spoke, according to the report. The video reportedly did not include the alleged rape. Myers also says he saw footage that showed Brooks inside Reggie's earlier in the night as she struggled to stand up and could be seen falling. The judge reportedly said he believes, based on the footage and other evidence, that a crime occurred. So, yeah, I mean, it's just very, very unfortunate, guys. I mean, should have never happened whatsoever. And they were wrong for video, like, who records a girl, like, in the car that you don't even know? This was a stranger to these. All of these people were strangers. The four guys knew each other. So it was four on one, okay, off the top. She was definitely way drunker, like, to the point of falling down, slurring her speech, not knowing where she lived, all of these things. And they're laughing at her in the car and recording her and then leaving her on the side of the road. And you're going to tell me that nothing bad happened, nothing nefarious was up? Just it's giving dishonest. It's giving, I don't know. I don't know, guys. What is it giving to y'all? I would love to know y'all's opinion on that. And if you like the video, please give it a like, guys. Definitely give me your thoughts in the comments down below. And yeah, y'all make sure stay safe out there because this is the type of shit that we're dealing with, and this is the tragic type of instance where it's easily preventable. So I don't see how we can just, how we can just say that like this was all above board and like that nothing bad happened here. It's just a case of a drunk girl who, had a terrible accident. No, I think we need to do some more reflecting and really ask ourselves the tough questions. And if you are a young man out there, you need to protect yourself just as much as young women do. So, yeah, guys. And make sure you all subscribe on the way out, please. I would so love that for us. And until next time, guys, y'all stay safe. See y'all later. Okay? Bye.